हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट दी पेपर नंबर 7, दैट इज अ माइक्रोबियल जेनेटिक्स एंड मोलिकुलर बायोलॉजी ऑफ सेमिस्टर नंबर 4. इट हैज़ अ टू क्रेडिट्स, वन दैट इज अ फर्स्ट वन, दैट इज अ क्रेडिट नंबर फर्स्ट, दैट इज अ माइक्रोबियल जेनेटिक्स एंड सेकंड वन दैट इज अ मोलिकुलर बायोलॉजी. सो इन टू द प्रेजेंट लेक्चर वी विल बी डिस्कस इन डिटेल द वट इज द सिलेबस ऑफ माइक्रोबियल जेनेटिक्स. Into this microbial genetics, that is a point A, that is the basic concepts of gene, and into the point B, that is a mutation. So, in case of the basic concepts, there are, that is a point first, that is the forms of DNA. So, DNA, it is a deoxyribonucleic acids. They will be classified into these specific forms of DNA. These are A form, B form, C form, D form, and Z form. So, near about the 5 different forms of DNA are there. Into that, the most studied model of the DNA, that is a B form of DNA. On the basis of the X-ray crystallography, according to the Watson, Crick, Wilkin and Franklin, the specific types of the DNA, there is a DNA, it is a double helix on the basis of the X-ray crystallographic structure. So these are classified into these 5 basic types. So they have the variable number of base pairs, also variable number of variable, that is the distance in between the two strands, also the variable that into the distance in between the adjacent nucleotides. So these are all number of characteristics of the different forms will be studied into the forms of DNA. After that, there is a point B, that is a gene, genome, genotype and phenotype. Gene, genome, genotype, phenotype, mutagen, recon, muton and cystone. In short, the gene, it is a structural and functional unit of the genome. Gene, it is a structural and functional unit of the genome. So second one, that is a genome. Genome, it is a group of genes. Genome, it is a group of genes. Genotype, it is a specific specific structure of the specific structure of the gene, that is hereditary. They will be responsible for the hereditary and variations. The number of genes, they will be transferred from the one generation to the next one. And these specific types of the characteristics of the genes are studied in case of the genotype. Then phenotype. Phenotype, it is the external appearance of that person. External appearance of that specific person or specific bacterial cell, viruses or any other, any specific living things or living cell, they have the specific types of the phenotype because of their genotype. And we have the specific visible characteristics of that specific cell. It is called as a phenotype. Then exactly that in case of the genotype and phenotype, that is genotype, there are specific types of the structure of gene, they will be responsible for the hereditary and variations. And phenotype, it is a specific types of the structural appearance or visible appearance of that specific cell, it is known as a phenotype. Then mutagen. Mutagen, it is a specific fragment of the gene, they will be responsible for the mutation. Mutagen, it is a specific fragment of the gene, they will be responsible for the mutation. Then next one, that is a recon. Recon, it is a specific types of the gene, or it is a fragment of gene, or it is a specific type of the gene, they will be responsible for the recombination. Then the next one, that is a muton. The specific types of the gene, they will be responsible for the mutation. Then next one, cystone. Cystone, a specific cell, they have the specific central dogma, that is the DNA, they get converts into the DNA by the process of replication. DNA get converts into the RNA by the process of transcription, and this same RNA, they will be converts into the proteins by the process of translation. So the specific DNA get converts into the DNA, that is a no any change into the final structure, only the change is that into the new DNA, that is a one strand, it is a new one, and one strand is a old one. So they have that no any change into the forms, the directly DNA get converts into the new DNA, that is a cis conformation. So these are the both are same, the initial compound and final compound both are same. So because of this, these are considered as a cis. But in case of the transcription and translation, in case of the transcription, the DNA get converts into the RNA, and in case of the translation, RNA get converts into the proteins. So in these two processes, the specific, they will be changed their forms, and because of their change of their forms, so these are considered as a trans. So the specific gene, they have ability to cis and trans, both of these are called commonly as a cistron. These are commonly called as a cistron. So the specific types of the gene or fragment of gene, they have ability to replication, transcription and translation, these are called as a cistron. Then next one, that is a point C, there is a split genes. Split genes are also known as interrupted genes. So the number of genes, they have the specific types of the also coding as well as non-coding regions. So they have the coding as well as non-coding region. Coding genes are the specific types of, these are the messengers. They have the code for the specific gene, they have code for the specific characteristics. And non-coding genes, they already do not code any specific amino acids. So the split genes are commonly known as the interrupted genes, or the specific inverted repeats of introns and exons are called as split genes. So these are the specific term, that is a split genes. By the process of splicing, after the formation of mRNA or hnRNA, before the mRNA, that is hnRNA, so into the maturation process, the specific post transcription modification takes place, that is 5' capping, splicing and polyetylling, and these specific split genes are modified by the process of splicing. Then the point D, that is a genetic code, definition and properties of genetic code. The specific types of the genetic code, the each and every nucleotide that consists the either purines or pyrimidines. Purines like adenine, guanine, and pyrimidines like thymine, cytosine in case of the DNA. But by using a specific code, specific nucleotides, they can form a codon. It is of the triplet. So three specific nucleotides come together and form a one single codon, and this single codon, they have code the specific amino acids. So according to this, the 64 codons, they will be synthesized the 20 amino acids. That's 20 amino acids to 20 standard amino acids, and these are codes by the 64 codons. Into that, 61 are sense codons and 3 are nonsense codons. So according to this, the specific codons, they will be synthesized the 20 amino acids. So these specific types of the amino acids are manipulated into the specific board, and this is called as a genetic code. So the definition and properties of the genetic code, they will be discussed into the point D. It is about the basic concepts of gene. Then the next one, that is a mutation. The point B, that is a mutation. So mutations, the mutation, it is also known as a sudden change into the genetic material. It is called as a mutation. Sudden change into the genetic material is called as a mutation. Sudden irreversible change, it is called as a mutation. So the basic concept of mutation, that is a base pair substitution, frame shift mutation, missense mutation, nonsense mutation, neutral mutation, silent mutations, pleiotropic and suppressor mutations. They are the variable types of mutations. Into that, the base pair substitutions are carried out by either transition and transversion. Transition means a specific nucleotide base. The specific nucleotide base in case of the DNA replication, this one strand, it is a complementary to another. And at the position of the one strand, there it is adenine. At the exactly opposite to this, there is a thymine. So adenine pairs with the thymine, and guanine always pairs with the cytosine. These are the correct base pairing. But in some cases, some adenine pairs with the guanine or adenine pairs with the cytosine, these are the cross matches, and these cross matches because of the mutation, and they can synthesize the wrong amino acid at the time of the translation. So the specific types of the mutations are classified into different types. That is the first one, base pair substitution, either by transition and translation. Frame shift mutation, most of the times it is happens in case of the macrolations at the chromosomal levels. The specific fragment of the chromosome, they will be deleted, inserted, or inserted and deleted. Because of this, they will be breakdown, they will be changed the specific frame. So these are called as a frame shift mutation. Then missense mutation. Missense means they will be lost their sense. So because these of this, these are called as a missense. So the specific types of the amino acid, they can lost their sense, or the specific sense codon, they will be converted into the nonsense one. These are known as a missense mutation. Then nonsense mutation, the specific types of the umber, occur and OPAL, the UAA, UAG and UGA, these are the three stop codons or nonsense codons. These stop codons or nonsense codons, if they are the mutated, they will be converts from nonsense to sense one. These are known as a nonsense mutation. Then neutral mutation, The specific types of the intron mutation, the near about 61 codon codes for the 20 amino acid. Sometimes the specific one amino acid is coded by the more than one codon. That in the specific after the mutation, the codon will be changed, but no any change to the amino acid synthesis. These types of the mutations are known as the neutral mutations. Then silent mutation, the specific types of the mutations are happens at the coding region, but these are not expressed into their phenotype. These are known as a silent mutation. Then pleiotropic and suppression mutation. The pleiotropic means the specific variable pleiotropic. Pleiotropic in the sense the specific types of the they are the duplicate. They will be show the specific duplications into their phenotype. The change in their genotype, but the specific not any specific visible change on their phenotype. These are known as a pleiotropic. Then suppressor mutation. Suppressor mutation. The specific mutations. Happens in a specific genetic material, but these mutations are suppressed by the secondary mutations. These types of mutations are known as the suppressor mutations. Then point B, that is the spontaneous mutations. Spontaneous are known as a natural mutation. Natural mutations. So natural mutations are happens because of the errors into the DNA replication. Sometimes some the enzymes are deficient, they are unable to carry out their work properly. At that time, the specific types of the wrong base pairs are incorporated into the newly synthesized DNA. These types of the mutations are known as the spontaneous mutations. Then the point C, that is the induced mutations. Induced mutations, these are induced by the specific mutagenic agent or mutagen. The specific types of the mutations are induced by the specific mutagenic agent or mutagens are known as the induced mutations. For example, base analogs like fibromyrcel, 2-aminopurines, then mutagens modifying nitrogenous bases, that is a nitrous acid, that is a hydroxylamine, alkylating agents. These are the specific mutagenic mutagens modifying nitrogenous bases. Then also mutations that distort the DNA, that is acridine dyes and ultraviolet radiations. UV radiation, it is a physical mutagenic agent, and except ultraviolet radiation, the others are chemical mutagenic agent. Either the specific types of the mutations are either biological, chemical or physical. Biological, like the specific types of the viruses, they have ability to cause the mutations. Chemicals like acridine dyes, fibromyrcel, 2-aminopurines, hydroxylamine, alkylating agents, these are the specific types of, for example, nicotine, these are also chemical mutagenic agents. Physical mutagenic agent like the ultraviolet radiation, X-ray, gamma ray, alpha particles, these are also physical mutagenic agents. So they have ability to cause the mutation. So these types of the mutations are commonly comes under the induced mutations. So it is about the detailed syllabus of unit number 1st of microbial genetics, paper number 7. So it is a total syllabus of the credit 1st or unit 1st, that is the microbial genetics, into that basic concepts and mutation, into that forms of DNA, gene, genome, like the specific definition, genetic code, mutations, into that basic concept of mutations. These are the types of mutation, and also spontaneous mutations and induced mutation. These are all of this are comes under the unit number 1st. So from the next lecture, we will be discuss in detail the overall syllabus of the paper number 7, unit number 3.